I've checked it over, and I have to say that actually, legally, the Streamberry Corporation can do this.
What? How?
Trust me, I'm as shocked as you are.
But the show is using my life. It's my name, it's my career, it's me. They're using me, so...
And you assign them the right to exploit all of that.
What? When?
Terms and conditions.
I have never seen this before.
You have. You just haven't seen it printed out before. All of that would have popped up on your phone or whatever when you first signed up to Streamberry, and you clicked accept.
But, I mean, how was I supposed to know this?
I know, but you did accept it, and so they're in the clear.
No. They can't do this to me.
There are only so many ways for me to tell you that they absolutely can.
Okay, well, Salma Hayek.
Yeah, pretty cool.
No, I'm gonna sue Salma Hayek.
For what?
For like passing herself off as me. She has no right to do that.
Well, it's not really Salma Hayek.
Yes, it is.
No, technically, the show deploys a digital likeness of Ms. Hayek. They don't film her. She licensed her image to them. The entire show is CGI. It's generated by some kind of super advanced, deepfake, quantum computer mumbo jumbo. They could make Salma Hayek blow an orangutan if they wanted to.
Oh.
I'm guessing Ms. Hayek might object to that, but you get my point.
Right, so it's all computers.
That's how they get it on the surface so fast.
But how do they even know what I'm doing? It's the same day.
Well, you know when you got your phone face down on the table and you're in your kitchen and you're talking to your friend about, I don't know, shoe deodorizers. And then, you know, you go on your computer and what pops up? A shoe deodorizing ad. And then you get an email. And it's all about shoe deodorizing, and then you're walking down the street and shoe deodorizing, mm-hmm. and you can't escape it, and it's...
Yeah, so?
That's how they know.
Okay, but... but the show makes stuff up about me, right? It embellishes things, it makes me look worse than I really am, so defamation.
Yeah, page 53, paragraph 12, there's something about creating characters and dialogue for dramatic purposes.
Fuck!
I agree. I hate to say it, but this thing is watertight.
Oh, thank God.
They got you every which way and then some. My advice is to try and ignore it.
What the fuck kind of advice is that?
It's the only kind I got.